like I'm always interested about like what I cannot see and what is like, behind what I can see. I don't make my artwork because of fun. I need make work because I need to find answer, or I need to find a question. I'm always want to be under the water, or I'm interested about water itself. And I want to make something out of water, but it's impossible. So I was looking for some material very similar to water, and I found glass, and I really want to create something out of glass. That's how I decide to be artist. I'm more like a concept-based artist, so I'm very slow to work, but I really want to be comfortable and confident to find my interest. If my interest is not deep enough, I can't keep working, you know? I cannot lie to my work, so I really have to find my core and also honest, like in interest. Toyama, where I used to live, and then Kanazawa, where I live, is in the same region we called Hokuriku region. And the Hokuriku region's weather is very similar to like Scandinavian, like always cloudy, rainy. I'm very affected by weather. If in sunny days, I want to be more active, so I want to go outside. But in the rainy days, like, you know, also rain sound is makes me so calm and relaxed. And then I decided to make work of how we can appreciate sunshine and how people can enjoy rain, or how I can change the perspective of enjoyment of rain, because people think about rains like a negative way, like, you know, you can get wet or you cannot go outside. But actually I'm really enjoy rain so much because I can be calm, and also I like the rainy sound. Yeah, so I'm really appreciate it, rain so much, because I can appreciate even like a little sunshine after the rain is gone. I feel that Japanese glass art is still like very young, since like we have like a long history about ceramics and metal and lacquer as our artwork. Like the glass is still new, like maybe like 30 or 40 years. So still like we're trying to develop like, you know, what we can do with glass. So, but for me, is glass as a one of vehicle or tool to express my idea and my concept. People don't get it. Why are you using glass as a metaphor or tools? That's the kind of things I'm struggling a lot, because people don't look at glass that way. But I wanna do what I want to do with glass.
日本の伝統工芸っていうのは そもそもものすごく地域性が強いものなんですね。で、柄だけどガラスにはそれがほぼない、キリコはまだ伝統工芸としてあるんですけれども、素材がその土地由来のものっていうのがやっぱり伝統工芸ではすごく強いと思うんですよね。でそれがガラスにはない、つまり土地と紐づいていない、そういう制約がないっていうところが、実はそのいろんなしがらみから離れて自由な表現が出てきやすいんじゃないのかなって私は思っているんですね。なのでガラスはもうこれから、日本においてはかもしれないですけど、美術のヒエラルキーを楽々とこう超えていくような、そういうポテンシャルも実は一番高い素材なんじゃないかなと思っています。
そうですね、日本のガラスの作家さんは、多くの方はやはりそのオブジェクトベースというかね、なんか作品を作ってそれを完成させる、そこで一つのものが完結するというような感じの作品が多いんですけれども、ルイさんの場合は作品が例えばインスタレーションであったりとか、そのガラスの使い方もその単にその素材という、もちろん表現素材ではあるんですけれども、なんか私の印象ではすごくそのプロセスや何かも含めて思考のための素材というふうな感じで捉えているのかなというふうに思います。でそういった感じでガラスの作品を作っている、あるいはその美術の作品を作っている作家さんというのは日本ではあまり僕は知らないので、とてもユニークな存在じゃないかなというふうに思います。
I'm making out of like a drop shape with phosphorescent light, and then I'm gonna hang, and then I'm gonna put solarium light with them. I use solarium light, which is like a fake sunshine, and then I'm gonna set up the motion detector, so when visitors coming to see the work, motion detector gonna react, and then people can see the phosphorescent glowing dark.I'm interested about not just making installation, it's more like interactive, because of I feel that weather is really affect physically and mentally. I got inspiration from here because the weather is constantly changing. We never can guess what kind of sunshine we get, so the visitor never can guess how bright my work is. The artwork is like depending on like viewers. They're staying there long enough.The phosphorescent glass is gonna be like fade out. So when viewers gonna be gone from the exhibition, maybe they can appreciate more natural light or sunshine.